before I go to sleep. On bended knees, these are the words I speak. Keep me, Lord, so I won't go astray. It's my desire to live for you each day, Lord. I try the best I can in all my ways, acknowledge Him, keep the faith, and always pray. And the closer I get to you, teach me, Lord, for your word is alive to me. I surrender my all to you completely. Oh, I try the best I can, and always acknowledge Him, keep the faith, and day of my life, every day I try to live, in everything I do, yes, whoa, 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 I try to live, the best I can in every day, every way, oh, I try to live, oh my, whoa.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm so glad that you've come and joined us this morning on this first Sunday as we come to fellowship together as one, as Jesus and his disciples had fellowship. Amen. As Jesus has told us, come together as often as we can in fellowship, in the breaking of bread, in the celebration of God loving us so much that he made provisions for us to be a part of the family, to make provision for us that we might have life, to make provision for us that we might be a family in God. I'd like to welcome those out on the phone line, amen. I'd like to welcome out there Sister Betty Strickland. I pray you had a good time, amen, while you was on vacation, amen. I just want to say hello to Janice and Henry Lowe. Welcome you all and your family, amen. I'd like to welcome John Lovell and Curtis Lowe, amen. I'd like to welcome all those out there on in virtual land, amen. I see, amen, Sister Persley, amen. Maddie, good to see you out there. I see a team member out there, Sister Cornelius, amen. I see Reverend Lorenfro. I see Deaconess Thomas out there as well, amen. If you're out there, just type out your name. Type, just say hello, amen, that we can welcome you on the broadcast as we come together. Hey, I see Sister Moten out there. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Good to see you. I see Sister Butler. She's out there. Amen. Praise the Lord. Sister Walker, welcome, welcome. Keep on typing. Let me know that you're out there. Amen. I see Sister Hall. She's out there as well. We're just out there. Invite people to come in. Start a watch party. Let us all come together today and worship our God in spirit and in truth, because she does love us. He does love us. God will be a mother. God will be a father. God will be a sister, brother. God will be all that we need. But we need to come and lift up our worship that God might inhabit our praises. Amen. Amen. Let's get on into our announcements. Amen. We know that this is First Sunday, so we have to do communion. So let us sit back and listen to the announcements.
Good morning, Camp Hope family. Here are your announcements for today. Every Tuesday, we have a prayer line that occurs at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time and 6 p.m. Central Standard Time, hosted by Reverend Ida Sue Graham and Reverend LaTanya Renfro. You can join us by calling in at 978-990-5041. With the access code of 675984. And during this prayer line, you can submit your prayer requests. So for anyone you would like for us to pray for, to keep in mind, to lift up to God, you can add them to our prayer list. So you can come out on our prayer line on every Tuesday and submit their name. You can let us know on Facebook Messenger, or you can let us know by simply typing us a comment on our Facebook page. Don't forget to follow us on all of our social platforms. We are on Facebook at Camp Hope, or you can search MED-Camp Hope. You can also find us on YouTube by searching Camp Hope AME Church. Or you can find us on Instagram at Camp Hope AMEC. You can become a virtual member anytime throughout service, or you can message us on Facebook. You can email us at camphopeamec@gmail.com, or you can write to us at 114 Camp Hope Church Road, Macon, Georgia, 31211. Every Wednesday we have Bible study. We are currently in Exodus chapter 32, moving right along in our Exodus study. So if you would like to join us, we will be out here on Facebook Live, or you can call into our phone line at 6:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 5:30 p.m. Central Standard Time, and you can call in on our conference line at 978-990-5041 with our code of 675-984. Also, we are looking for volunteers. The Macon East District Media Resource Team is looking for any volunteers that are young adults just to help out with any other churches in the district for monitor streaming. We're also looking for people to interact with our community during service, or if pastors need assistance with troubleshooting technology. So our media resource team is looking for any young adult volunteers. If you would like more info, please contact us at mediaresource.med@gmail.com if you would like to volunteer, or if you know someone who you think would like to volunteer. Don't forget, our SED and annual conference donations are still going on. Our due date is May 5th, so we're looking to get any donations that are our last minute requests. We are requesting a donation of $200 per member, and if you could please submit those via Cash App at $CampHopeAMEC, at PayPal at paypal.me/CampHopeAMEC, or you can just search for us on Givelify, and you can also find one of your class leaders and they will be able to give it to us as well. Did you know that Governor Brian Kemp signed a bill, SB 202, into law, which means it will be a criminal offense to provide food or water to voters waiting in long lines at the voting polls, as well as new additions to ID requirements, which could stop thousands of voters from voting by mail. If you would like to sign the petition by the New Georgia Project Action Fund, then we can stop this action. We want Congress to protect our voting rights. Please go to www.ngpaf.org/HR1 to sign this petition to let Governor Brian Kemp know that we do not want this bill into law and that we would prefer HR1 and HR4 to expand voting rights for all. Also, don't forget to check your voter's status. So if you do not know, or if you are not sure, if you have a valid voter's registration, please go to register2vote.sos.ga.gov in order to check, just to make sure everything is valid. Also, we have some church meetings coming up at Camp Hope. We have a board meeting, which will be held this Monday, May 3rd at 6:30 p.m. And also, we will be having church conference on May 17th at 6:30 p.m. as well. And these are Eastern Standard Time. We will be in person at Camp Hope, and we will be doing it via Zoom. And we will be posting the Zoom link for anyone who would like to attend virtually. Also, Camp Hope and the YPD Ministry are hosting a yard sale and giveaway. This will be Saturday, May 15th from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. at Camp Hope. We will also be selling cake slices and candy apples, and all of the proceeds will go to the support of Camp Hope AME Church. And that's it for our announcements. Have a great day.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm ready to start praising. Are you ready to start praising? Come on, let's get into our praise and worship. And remember, while we're praising and worshiping, amen, we need to just be typing in, saying something, letting people know that we're praising God together. I see some others have come in. I see Sister Barabino. She's come in. Good to see you, our full member. Praise the Lord. I see Veronica Williams. Sister Veronica Williams, she's come in. Amen. I see Sister Sheila, hallelujah, Giddens, she's here with us today. I see Reverend Ida Sue Graham, who's out there in Ohio. She's with us this morning, praise the Lord. I see our WMS president, Sister Eddie Mae Hall, has joined in with us today. Just type something in. Let us know that you're there, that we can just acknowledge you and say, thank you for coming in. We thank all of our partners. We thank all of our members. We thank all of our friends. We thank everyone that has decided to tune in with us this morning as we come on this first Sunday to praise God and come together in communion, in fellowship. Let's listen to our praise and worship. Praise God.
That I'm thankful for my I'm thankful for my
see our member, virtual member, Sister Wooten, she's joined in with us as well. Amen. Did anybody else come in while we were praising God? Amen. Amen. Type something. Oh, Sister Burns out there in Leland, Mississippi. Hallelujah. Good to see you this morning. Happy Sunday. Praise God. Praise God. Anybody else? Just type out Type it in. Let us know that you're here praising God and worshiping God with us. Amen. Come on, let's get right into our call to worship. Amen. Our call to worship will be on the screen. Amen. You know how we do it. I'm going to say what the ministers say. Amen. Then I'm going to ask you to join in with me as we say what the people say. Are you ready? I know I'm ready. Praise God. Oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name together. Come on, say it with me. I was glad when they said to me, let us go to the house of the Lord. Our feasts have been standing within your gates, O Jerusalem. But the hour is coming, and now is, when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Come on, say it with me. How shall we sing the Lord's song in a foreign land? Do you not know that your bodies are the temples of the Holy Spirit who is in you? And though he slay us, yet shall we trust him. Come on, let us sing. Oh, let us sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. I will sing of loyalty and of justice to you. Oh, Lord, I will sing. Praise the Lord. Let us hear our song of praise this morning. Amen. I see Brother Stan Thomas out there, our Sons of Allen coordinator. Praise the Lord. Good to see you out there with us. Come on, let's get into our hymn of praise this morning.
spiritual father, Bishop Robert R. Sanders. He comes to the mic and say, I say yes to my Lord.
Say yes. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, I'm excited. I pray you're excited. I pray that you're praising God along with us today. Amen. It's time for prayer time, though. Amen. Remember, if your name is not on the prayer list or somebody that you know that's not on the prayer list or you need some special prayer today, amen, all you need to do is just type out the name, amen. We will call out that name as well, amen. And if you don't do that, you can come on our prayer line, amen, on Tuesday at 7 o'clock and let them know. They'll add it on there as well. But we truly have two great prayer warriors. Amen. Our prayer team who comes in and pray. Everybody gets an opportunity to say something to pray, to give a testimony. Amen. So let us know as we go now into prayer. God, we love you. Father, we love you. Mother, we love you. We love you, God. For you're a father, Abba Father, you are a mother to us, you are a sister, you are a brother, you are all that we need. We come before your throne of grace and mercy, humbly bow, but boldly. For you said if we're covered in the blood of Jesus, we can boldly come again and recognize you as our creator, our personal parent, our personal provider, our personal comforter, knowing, not guessing, knowing that you're there, knowing that you hear us, knowing that you will never leave us nor forsake us. We come to you, our God, who we know according to the word that looks beyond our faults and see our needs, who makes ways out of no way for us. And if we know that you're there and on our side, we don't have to worry about it anymore. We can trust in you. We can turn to you. We can know that you are right there with us. So we say to you, God, hear our humble prayer this morning. We pray for my family as we buried my first cousin, Diane or Patricia Cole Talbot yesterday. Pray for us as we celebrate her entrance into your holy place. but as we mourn that we will miss her. Carry us through, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We pray for our very own Sister Betty Desire. Strengthen her, keep her, empower her, restore her, bring her back to us once again. We pray for Reverend Charma as she's lost her granddaughter. We know that she's there with us, with you, but hold them as they miss her and they mourn her. Let them know that weeping may endure for a night, but joy will come. So we ask that you would comfort them and keep them until you allow that joy to come. Lord, we pray for all those that are out there on the prayer list. We pray that you would hear their humble cries. For Lord, so much is going on in our lives today. Some we've caused it, some we're reaping what we've sowed, but some are attacks from haters. Attacks from demonic spirits, attacks from not having confidence in ourselves, attacks in the name of Jesus. Comfort us, keep us. We pray for Amy and Patricia Wooten right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We pray for Sister Wooten, Mother Wood, right now, in the name of Jesus, Lord. You know, we can't read minds, but you hear our thoughts, Lord, for we know you know. Comfort us, keep us, carry us through. Lord, forgive us for our sins that we've done in thought, in word, and in deed, Lord. And Lord, we ask that you would let us be a testimony, be a witness of your love, of your grace, of your mercy. We thank you for restoring Sister Brenda Starchill back to health, Lord. For restoring Renee Winston back to health, Lord. For restoring Amber Holmes back, for restoring all those that you have allowed to beat this epidemic that's going through, Lord, to be a testimony of you. Guide our steps, Lord. Take us down the way we need to go. For we trust you, for we know that in the end, everything is going to be in the best that we would have it, you would have it to be for us. We pray for all those out there. And Lord, let a word come today, a word from you, a freeing word, a word that will lift us up and encourage us. This is our prayer. And Holy Spirit, there's something I should have prayed that I didn't pray. We ask that you would lift it up before the throne of grace and mercy. Bless the Riggins family. Bless the Camp Hope family. Bless all of our virtual members. Bless all of our partners. Bless all of our guests that's out there listening to us. Bless the African Methodist Episcopal Church, Lord. Bless the 6th Episcopal District and our Bishop, Bishop Reginald Jackson, as he leads us on the way. And let all of our efforts be through you, by you, and from you. And bless them. This we ask in your Son, Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and thank God. Hallelujah. We see some others just come out. Amen. We see Elvis Smith, one of my classmates. Good to see you. We see Regina Leonard out there. Praise the Lord. Amen. We see some others who have come out. Amen. We see Reverend Lawson is out there with us. We see Reverend Chalmer is out there with us. Amen. We see Sister, amen. Hallelujah. Akoff, we see her out there. Amen. We see, and I'm going to pronounce this wrong. Amen. Altha, A-L-E-T-H-A, amen. We see you out there, amen. Who else we got out there, amen? Just type something and let us know that you are out there with us today. And we thank you for joining us to doing what we need to do, amen. I see you, Sister Dalton, she's out there as well. Reverend Diana Dalton, good to see you out there as well. Amen. Well, guess what? It's time for scripture reading. Amen. So take out your swords right now. Take out your Bibles right now. It's only be two verses. Amen. Two verses. We want you to go back and read that whole chapter. We're going to talk about it as well. But we want to concentrate on two verses today. So open up your Bibles, if you will, to John chapter 20, verses 30 through 31. John chapter 20, verses 30 through 31. And for those that don't have your sword, it's out there on the screen, amen, and it reads, Jesus performed many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not recorded in this book. But these are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that by believing you may have life in his name. Amen. From all that dwells below the skies, let thy Creator's praise arise. Let the Redeemer's name be sung through every land by every tongue. Let us sing in a cappella. From all that dwells below the sky, let thy Creator's praise arise. Let thy Redeemer's name be sung through every land by every tongue. The sum of the Decalogue, hear what Christ our Savior said. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Let us sing the Glory, Patrick. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Amen. Thank God. Praise the Lord. Amen. Now it's time for our tithes and our offerings. Amen. We know what the Bible says about it. He says, God says, try me, test me, and see. One eye, open up the windows of heaven. All you need to do is allow God to prove God's self. And as you give, and give with the right intentions, and in the right mind, and in the right way, God will open up the windows of heaven, and you will know it's from God and no one else. God will open up the windows not just with money, but good health, sound mind, whatever those things you need. God will open up the windows of heaven, pour you out so much of those blessings that you will not have room to receive. But remember, if you have another church, amen, where you are a full member, amen, remember your tithes belong there. So make sure we're operating in a different season. We can't have programs, amen. So make sure you pay your tithes at the church where God has placed you and you have full membership. But we ask, if God has blessed you even more, God bless you in your offerings. So we pray that you will give offerings unto us. We ask our members that they would tithe as God has blessed them as well and give their offering, all of our partners. We could not do any of the things we would do without our members, without our covenant partners, without without our friends as you give, as God has blessed you. And I promise you, God will bless you. I know God blesses me. Amen. So please open up and allow God to show out in your life through giving. How can you give? You can give through Giblify. Amen. As on your screen, you can click on that link. You can give at Cash App, at $CampHopeAMEC. You can give via paypal.me/CampHopeAMEC. Amen. Or you can write us at Camp Hope AME Church, 114 Camp Hope Church Road, Macon, Georgia, 31211. Or you could contact one of the members, contact your class leader, amen. Let them know, they'll come by and pick it up, amen. Just give, for we know as you give, God will give to you. Believe it or not, I'm telling you, I know God will open up the windows, pull you out a blessing that you will not have room to receive. We thank you for giving. We thank our members. We thank our partners. Thank our covenant partners. Thank our virtual members. We thank you for all that you do. And I want you to know that a big project is undergo right now. Amen. We are getting ready to fit the church that we can continue doing live broadcasting in the church. We've already called people in. They've already came through and looked at everything, and they're writing up as we pray. Pray that God will give us mercy as they're writing up their estimate. But pray that we will have the right equipment, amen, the right broadband, the right strength, that we might be able to broadcast without problems, without glitches, amen, and bless those that are blessing us. So that project is coming, amen. We will be announcing that, amen, asking that you would support us as we put ourselves in a position that we can go out and broadcast all across the world. Amen. To reach those in Africa, reach those in Italy, reach those in Germany, reach those in Washington State, reach those in Florida, reach those everywhere across the United States. Amen. Where they can tune in to our broadcast, which is on Facebook, which is on YouTube, which is on Instagram. Amen. And God's going to be bringing some more ways that we are going to be able to broadcast, but we'll talk to you that later as God make that clearer unto us. Yes. Amen. Well, I'm ready. Are you ready for some word? I'm ready.
Yes.
So pray for me. Pray for me as I open up my heart, open up my mind, open up my spirit to allow the Holy Spirit to speak through me. The Holy Spirit will give you what God has for you to receive on this day. Let us listen to our selection for the sermon today.
Take the time. Than they are right now. That lets me know I'm blessed. When I look back over my life and see where he's brought me from, I know one thing, if I don't know nothing else, that I'm blessed. 'Cause if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, I don't know where, I don't know
Hallelujah. Amen. I see Tanjala, I hope I'm saying that right. Moten Williams, she's joined in with us. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glad that you are here with us. Amen. Let's get right into the word. Amen. Again, let's open our Bibles to John chapter 20, verses 30 through 31, as written on the screen there. Amen. John chapter 20, verses 30 through 31. And it says, Jesus performed many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not recorded in this book. But these are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that by believing, you may have life in his name. I've read to you John chapter 20, verses 30 through 31, the word of God for the people of God. Let us say thanks be unto God. Amen. I just want you to say life. Come on, say it again. Life. Let me pray. Lord God, we just thank you, we praise you, we glorify you for allowing you to be in us, in spite of. Be around us, be with us, in spite of. We thank you, Lord. If I've done anything in thought, word, and deed that hinder you from coming, forgive me right now in the name of Jesus. For these are your sheep. These are your people. So give them a word. Give them a word that will give them understanding. Give them a word that will allow them to be all that they can be. Glorifying the Father. Glorifying the Mother God. Glorifying you. Glorifying the heavenly host. Glorifying. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. And thank God. Amen. Life. Life. You know, in our text this morning, we can hear the Apostle John winding up his testimony. He says, Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which were not written in this book, but these were written for our benefit, that we may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the promised deliverer, the Savior of the world. Believe that Jesus is the Son of God, God's only begotten Son. For it is revealed in John 1, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him, Jesus, all things were made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. It tells us that John the Baptist bear witness of Jesus. And it says, we beheld his glory, the glory of the only begotten Son of God. These were done that we might come to believe. They were written that we may come to believe that God sent Jesus as a sacrifice for our sins. That Jesus was crucified and paid the ultimate price. For it tells us, for God so loved the world that he gave her only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in them shall not perish, but have eternal life. They were written that we would believe that Jesus rose from the dead. Mary Magdalene was a witness of this. Cleophas and his companion was a witness of this. The 11 disciples were witnesses of this. And if we would read Jesus' story in its entirety, not only just the believers, but even the Roman soldiers who was on guard, who was on watch that night, were even witnesses of this very rising of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. All of these were written that you might believe, that you may believe that Jesus is the Messiah, that Jesus is the Son of God, and that by believing, you might have life. There it is. Life in his name. You know, but within all these things, there is something that we seem to be missing. There is something that we are overlooking here in our text. You know, many Christians that I have known down through the years have always rejoiced about the afterlife, always rejoiced about the eternal life. They will say things like, when I get to heaven, I'm going to truly rejoice. They would say, I can't wait to get to the land of no more, where there's no more sickness, no more crying, no more worrying. And if not that, they would say things like, I can't wait to meet Jesus. I can't wait to move in my mansion where the streets are paved with gold. I can't wait to pull off my shoes so I can walk all over God's heaven. And their statements are well founded, for Jesus did say in John 14 and 2 and 3, it says, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go, Jesus said, I'm going to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you into myself, that where I am in those mansions, there ye may be also. And also says in John 3:16, God lets us know, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have eternal life. So yes, they were accurate and well-founded in their excitement about their heavenly destination. But there is more. There is more. Let's go back in our text. Our text says to us, Jesus performed many other signs in the presence of the disciples, which are not recorded in this book. But these are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Messiah, that Jesus is the Son of God, and that by believing, right here, by believing, you may have life in his name. Did you hear it? It says life in his name. Say life. Everybody is excited about heaven and forgetting about life. Let's pause here for a moment. Say again with me, say life. I know that life has its ups and downs, but believe it or not, many people, if not the majority of them, prefer life. And the eternal life can come later. Matter of fact, way later. And yes, the Bible does say that Jesus has taken away the sting of death. And death has been swallowed up in victory. For in John, in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, and I believe it's in 54 through 57, it declares death has been swallowed up in victory. Matter of fact, it says to death, where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? It tells us that the sting of death is sin, the power of sin is the law, but thanks be to God. He gives us the victory through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Say again with me, say life. But most people are not ready to die. Our text says, but these are written that you might believe. You may believe that Jesus, yes, is the Messiah. Yes, he's the Son of God. But, and that by believing, you may have life in his name. Jesus even testified concerning himself in John chapter 10, where he says to us, I, Jesus, am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved. He says they will come in, they will go out and find pasture. Then it says the thief only comes to kill, steal, and destroy. And here it is, Jesus testified concerning himself. He says, I have come. Come on, say it with me. Jesus has come. I have come that they might have life, hear it now, life and have it to the fullest, have it more abundantly. Jesus goes on and says, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd laid down his life for the sheep. Yes, God sent his son that we may have eternal life. But God also sent his son that we might have life and have it more abundantly. In this theologian's opinion, we spend too much time concentrating on eternal life rather than letting the Christians know that they can have a full life right here on earth.
Yes.
A life of joy. God will give them joy in the midst of the sorrow. God will give them joy in the midst of pain, in the midst of trouble. And they can declare, this joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me, nor can the world take it away. They can have a life of peace, for God will give you peace. Peace in the midst of calamity, peace in the midst of hardship, peace in the midst of undeserved shame. A peace that will surpass even our own understanding. A life where our needs will be met. Because God has promised, he says, I will supply all of your needs according to my riches in glory. But all we need to do, God said, is seek ye first the kingdom of God and God's righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto us. If you read before that, it talks about the lilies out there in the field. It talks about the King Solomon and his dress and birds and all the people, how God provides for them. All we need to do is seek first God, and all these things will be added unto us. And we also can have a life of heart-filled desires. Have mercy. But they need to be according to God's will and God's way. For Psalms 31 instructs us, if we would delight ourselves in the Lord, he will give us the desires of our hearts. In John 16 and 23, Jesus says, until now you have not asked for anything in my name. Jesus says, ask and you will receive and your joy will be made complete. The Christian life is more than just eternal life. It is an ever-present life. You know, some critics say that this was only for the Jews, but I tell them to go to read John chapter 1, verses 11 through 13. Where it says Jesus came to his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become the children of God. Children born not of natural descendants, non-Jews, nor of human decision or husband's will, but born of God. Right there. Now, this does not mean that life will be all peaches and cream. That would be wonderful. But if we would trust, if you would trust in the Lord with all your heart, do it God's way. Go by her instructions. Do it the way God has directed us to do it. And lean not to our own understanding, and in all our ways acknowledge God. God will direct our path. Jesus will lead us into an abundant life. A life where no weapon formed against us shall prosper. A life where all things will work out and work together for our good. a life where we are more than conquerors in Christ Jesus. Once we learn to react the way God tells us to react, once we can perceive it the way God tells us to perceive it, once we can love ourselves, love our neighbor, love our enemies, understand that we wrestle not against flesh and blood, against each other, but against this devil and his demonic influence upon our minds and our emotions, attempting to separate us, keep us divided, knowing that a house divided cannot stand. Once we can come together in unity, touching, agreeing, and praying together as God's children, Jesus will be in the midst of us.
Yes.
And once we study to show ourselves approval unto God, rightly dividing the word of truth. Once we can come together praising God with all of our hearts, in our thoughts, in our words, and in our deeds, God will, hallelujah, God will inhabit our praises. God will inhabit our spaces. God will inhabit all of our thanksgiving. God will be there, will never leave us nor forsake us. God will give us an abundant life. You know, we came from a long line of ancestors who sang songs to get them through, who sang songs, yes, in praise and worship, but when our ancestors sang those old spirituals, they were not only singing for the heavenly adventure, but they were singing to give instructions to those who were fleeing to freedom. They were giving instructions to those who were escaping to areas and states where they can live an abundant life not infected with the bondage of slavery. In Psalms 118, we hear David declaring in controversy, declaring in undeserved sickness. He declared, I will live and not die. And I will proclaim what the Lord has done. He says, though the Lord has chastened me severely, he has not given me over to death. Even David wanted life. Even David wanted to have life and have it more abundantly. Now it is true. It is true that we are appointed once to die and then the judgment. But Jesus instructs us that in him is life. And that life is the light of all who believe and accept him as their sacrifice. Who believe and accept him as their Lord and their Savior. And we who now have that light. Jesus says, you are the light of the world. And Jesus has commissioned us while we live this abundant life. The Great Commission charges us to go out into all the world. I want you to hear this. He charges us to do some traveling. You catch it now? To go out there on vacation. Come on now. Go out there shopping in the mall. Go out in your neighborhood. Go out in the highways and the valley. Get out sometime. Travel. Go across and do some things. Enjoy yourself. Have life and have it more abundantly. But while you're out there doing it, show how God is good to you. Charges us to be a witness while we out there, to tell our story while we're enjoying ourselves, to tell the story of God's gift to us, to go out there and be a testimony that will glorify our God. Let them know where God has brought you from and where God has led you to. Let them know that God looked beyond your faults. That you didn't have to get yourself together, get it all right before you came. God says, come just as you are. Let them know not only did Jesus die for their sins, but that he came that they might have life and have it more abundantly. Life. Come on, say it with me. Life. Type it out. Life. Type out abundant life. Yes, eternal life is coming. Yes. Streets are paved with gold is coming. Yes, we're going to be in a land of no more. Yes, those times are coming. But we want you to know that God says that Jesus has come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. So stop letting the devil steal your joy. Stop letting influences steal your peace. Stop letting situations and circumstances trouble you. Turn it over to the Lord. Let God lead us and guide us along the way. Step out and say, I will live and not die. Let proclaim the works of the Lord in my life. Trouble may come. Sorrows might come. But weeping endures for a night. Joy, hallelujah. Peace. Hallelujah. Needs being met. Hallelujah. Weapons being broke down. Hallelujah. We are being trained to be more than conquerors. Hallelujah. Every tongue shall be silenced. Hallelujah. God will allow us to live a life and live it more abundantly. Come on, shout out with me, life. I pray that you are excited the way I'm excited today, amen. For I've had my troubles, I've had some strict ways that have been put upon me. But once I learned about my God, once I learned about my Savior, once I learned to do it God's way, once I learned to trust God no matter what it looked like, no matter what it sounded like, no matter where I found myself in, I was able to live a life, an abundant life. Mm-hmm. So I want to tell you today, live an abundant life in the Lord. Mm-hmm. Do it God's way. Mm-hmm. Do it by God's will. Mm-hmm. Not when we sin, God says, ask for forgiveness. The more you know about God, know how great God is, the more you will be transformed and you won't even know it. You will be living an abundant life. God will, not might, give you life and give it to you more abundantly. We pray that the Holy Spirit has spoke to your hearts and your minds. We want to tell you now that the doors of the church are now open. Come and be a part of our family. All you need to do is confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that Jesus died for your sins and he rose from the dead. All you have to do is say, Jesus, come into my life. I accept you as my Lord and Savior. I accept you as a sacrifice for my life. Come back into my life. Lead me and guide me. Make me one of God's children. I believe. The door is open. Will there be one? I see my sister Melvia out there. Praise the Lord. Melvia Martin, good to see you as well. Hallelujah. Will you give your life to Christ? Will you become a virtual member? Will you become a full member? If you need prayer, this is the time. If you need baptism, this is your time. All of that is now open unto you. Jesus is now knocking on your door. Let us listen to our song of invitation as we listen to the Holy Spirit speak to our hearts.
We're living in a time where everybody is struggling for their lives. The stressed, the depressed, with the power invested in me, I came to speak life over you. I speak blessings of health, blessings of peace. To my brothers and sisters all around the world, especially those in South Africa, struggling with AIDS, in Brazil, the States.
I speak life, you're gonna live. Oh, my brother, my sister, I speak life. You are the head and not the tail. You will prevail. I speak life. Don't give up the fight for your life. You shall live and not die.
Let's not lose another person to a senseless death. Substance abuse, gang violence, suicide because of low self-esteem. The power of life and death is in the tongue. Speak life over yourself and those you love.
Help me sing it.
I speak life, you're gonna live. Oh, my brother.
Say it again.
Sister, I speak life, you are the head and not the tail. You will remain.
Say. Sister, yeah.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Excuse me. I tell you, I'm all choked up. Amen. Our God is such a good God. We pray right now. If you have said, Jesus, I accept your life, let us know. Need baptism, let us know. You want to be a virtual member, let us know. A covenant member, let us know. Let us know. Now is the time. Now it's time for us to go into Holy Communion. Amen. We pray that you would get your wine, get your grape juice. Some that may need water, get your water, amen. Get your crackers, your bread. Come on, let us get ready and for Holy Communion. Amen. Let us get ready for Holy Communion. Hallelujah. Are you ready? I know I'm ready. Amen. And it says, ye that do and truly and honestly repent of your sins are in love and charity with your neighbor, and intend to live a new life, following the commands of God, and walking from henceforth in his holy way, draw near. Draw near with your wine, draw near with your grape juice, draw near with your water, draw near with your bread, draw near. Hallelujah. Draw near and take up this holy sacrifice. Draw near with faith and take of this sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession to Almighty God. And out there on the screen, let us say our humble confession together. Let us say it together. Almighty God, Father our Lord Jesus Christ, make of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we have done from time in thought, word, and deed. Hallelujah.
Against your divine majesty.
Provoking most justly your wrath and indignation against us. We do honestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please you in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, whom of thy great mercy have promised forgiveness of sin, and to all them that with heartily repentance and true faith turn unto thee, have mercy upon us. Pardon and deliver us from all of our sins. Confirm our faith and strengthen us in all goodness, and bring unto everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Let us say amen. Almighty God, whom of hearts are open, hallelujah, and all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, ever through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. It is very meet and right, and our bountiful duty, that we should at all times and all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy holy name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Let us say amen. Lord, we do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same, Lord. who's probably as always to have mercy. Let us shout, grant us. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat, hold up your bread, your cracker, to eat, again, hold up your bread and your cracker, to eat the flesh of thy dear son, Jesus Christ, hallelujah, and to drink his blood, hold up your wine, hold up your grape juice, hold up your water, hallelujah. That our sinful bodies and soul may be made clean by his death and washed through his blood. And that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Let us say amen. Almighty God, Heavenly Father, whom of thy tender mercy did give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death on the cross for our redemption, who made thereby his oblation of himself once offered a full and perfect, sufficient sacrifice and oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel commanded us to a continual and perpetual memory of that his precious death until his coming again. Let us shout, hear us! Hear us, O merciful Father. We most humbly beseech thee and grant that we, receiving these creatures of bread, hold up your bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, wholly instituted in his remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of the most blessed body and blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it. Hold up your bread. And gave it to his disciples, saying, take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. Hold your cup up. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink ye all of it. For this is my blood, the blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sin. Do this as often as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me. Now let us take our bread. And let us hold it up and let us eat it. Let us take up the blood, our wine, our water. Let us drink. And we pray and celebrate that Jesus loved us so much that he gave us a life, his life, for a sacrifice for you and me. And we ask that you would take hold of the new covenant, which is to love God with all your heart and all your soul and all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. Now let us join together in the Lord's Prayer. Let us say, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we have forgiven those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. O Lord, our heavenly Father, we, thy humblest servants, desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto you, O Lord, ourselves, our souls, and our bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and lively sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching that all we who are partakers of this holy communion may be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction. And although we be unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bountiful duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father, almighty, world without end. Amen. And we say, glory be to God on high, on earth, peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks unto thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord God, the begotten, only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that taketh away the sins of the world, let us shout, have mercy upon us. Thou that taketh away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sitteth at the right hand of God, the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, are most high, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessings of God Almighty, the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Hallelujah. We just thank God, amen, that we could come together and fellowship, as for God has told us, Jesus has told us, do this as often as ye would in remembrance of me. Hallelujah. You know, I love you. I love you with the love of Christ. I pray that you're loving each other. I pray that we are doing it God's way, because I'm living my life. I pray you will be able to live an abundant life in Jesus. All right, time has been well spent. Amen. Let us sing our fellowship song together. What a fellowship. What a joy divine. Hallelujah.
Everlasting arms. What a blessedness. What a peace is mine. I'm leaving. so sane.
Apostle Creed, amen. Let's say it together. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, the only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he arose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Church Universal, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. May God bless you. May God keep you. May he smile upon you. May he give you peace is our prayer. Amen. We thank you for tuning in with me. Thank you for our covenant partner. Thank you for our members. We thank you for our guests. We thank you for inviting others to come. We thank you, our family, that you are here with us. We pray for you. We ask you that you continue supporting us, for we cannot do this without you. And know that we love you with the love of Christ. Tune in on our phone lines on Tuesday at 7 o'clock for our prayer line. Amen. Come back Wednesday. We'll be in Exodus chapter 32. Is that correct? Amen. 32. So let's read up on it before we get there. Amen. Then we'll be back out here again Sunday. We know Sunday is Mother's Day. Hallelujah. We just praise God and thank God for all of you mothers that are out there. Remember, tomorrow I will be at Campo Baby Church, 114 Campo Church Road. We'll be having our official board meeting. Remember, also on May 17th, we will be having our church conference that we can organize the church, amen, to get started for the new year to do what God has called us to do. I love you. Thank you. Tune in again next time. Love you. God bless you.